We want to use a unit circle to determine the domain of the secant and cosecant functions. Remember, if we have a circle with the center at the origin and an angle sketched in standard position, cosine theta can be defined by x divided by r, where r would be the radius of the circle, and x would be the x-coordinate of the point where the terminal side intersects the circle. And sine theta can be defined by y divided by r. Of course, for the unit circle, we know r would be equal to 1, but this would work for any circle as well, as long as the center is at the origin. And then, since the secant and cosecant functions are reciprocals of cosine and sine, secant theta is equal to r divided by x, and cosecant theta is defined by r divided by y. And since we know division by 0 is undefined, we must exclude the angles where the x-coordinate would be 0 on the unit circle from the domain of secant theta, and we must exclude the angles from the domain of the cosecant function where the y-coordinate would be 0 on the unit circle. So let's start by determining the terminal sides of the angles that must be excluded from the domain of the secant function. So we'll locate where x is equal to 0. Notice how x is equal to 0 here and here, which means any angle that has a terminal side along the positive y-axis or the negative y-axis cannot be in the domain of the secant function. So let's just start listing some of these angles. Of course, we'd have pi over 2, and then we'd have 3 pi over 2. Of course, we could also list negative angles, but we'll stick with positive ones for right now. The next one would be plus pi, that'd be 5 pi over 2. And notice how each time we're just adding another pi. The next one would be 7 pi over 2, and so on. So if we start with pi over 2 radians, we can just add or subtract multiples of pi radians, and those are the values that must be excluded from the domain. So the domain for the secant function would be all reals where theta does not equal pi over 2 radians plus pi times k, where k would be some integer, meaning 0, positive or negative 1, positive, negative 2, and so on. And again, this is the domain for the secant function. Now let's talk about the domain of the cosecant function. We can determine which angles to exclude by determining where the y-coordinate would be 0. And the y-coordinate would be 0 here and here, meaning we must exclude the angles that have a terminal side here and here. Again, let's go ahead and just start listing them. We'd have 0 radians, then we'd have pi radians, and then we'd have 2 pi radians. And now you can probably see the pattern already. The next one would be 3 pi, 4 pi, and so on. So the domain of the cosecant function would be all reals where theta does not equal any multiple of pi or pi times k, again, where k is some integer. Again, this is the domain for the cosecant function. And of course, we could do something similar for tangent and cotangent. I hope this was helpful.